We have an incident where a life was taken, and that's the business we're in, is life and deaths occur every day in law enforcement. And it affects everyone in this community. It affects the entire agency that it happens in. And there's been a lot of things said about the sheriff's office that are untrue. And hopefully I'll be able to answer some of those questions today. First, I want to speak directly to the Harris family. We are sorry Eric was taken from you. For this, I'm sorry that you all were involved, and my sympathy goes out to that family. I think it's very important anytime a life is lost in our community that we all need to stop and hesitate and say a prayer.
Sheriff, I know hindsight is 2020, but given what you know now, should Mr. Bates have been out there that day?
Yes, he should have been.
Why is it necessary for a reserve officer, a reserve deputy, to be involved in an undercover sting?
He wasn't involved in the undercover sting. He was there as backup. There were 9 deputies at that location, and Bob was one of those. He was a reserve. I have reserve deputies on the SOT team. I have I have 2 that are work for IMSA, which is the medical, they run the ambulance here in town. They go out with us, and they're there when, in case there is an incident, like someone's injured, we can provide medical aid specifically. I have 2 other deputies that have been on there. One is who was my attorney and good friend, Reuben Davis. He served on the SOT team. And I know Bob's age came up in this investigation as well. Reuben's 70 years old. Reuben felt that he no longer could provide the activities that were required to be on the SOT team. He moved to the, he became a hostage negotiator, but now he's even resigned from that, but he's still a reserve deputy.
Sheriff, what about the training position has affected your ability to lead, and do you have any plans to resign from the office?
No, I do not.
Why not?
And, well, I've been elected 7 times by this community. Last year I had an issue on the jail, and I was received a lot of support since this has occurred. I've had a lot of people call me and tell me that do not resign, that they don't question my integrity, and they're not sure why everyone else is, other than what a plaintiff's attorney has put out with several people that I have disciplined and fired from this office. And that's some of your sources.
Obviously, it's been a very difficult time for you and for everybody here. What has it been like for you? I know you're frustrated with us.
Well, one of the things I tell all my employees, is I have priorities in my life. And first is to my God. Number 2 is my family. And 3rd is being sheriff. And the reason I wasn't here Friday is I had planned a trip with my wife, and we went on it. So.
Okay.